The Cranes were slow in their build-up match against DR Congo, which they lost 1-0 and only got in the game in the second half, a trend they must reverse in order to stand a chance against their more technically gifted opponents. Cranes will have to look at Salim Magola, Regis Matt, among others, for inspiration.
Yeah, I know Algeria is a big team, it's a top team in Africa. So we as Ugandan players, we know always we fight with the big team. So I know our players and their character. I know we're going to fight to achieve what we want.
Mato off the bench scored at the death to hand Uganda Cranes a needed 1-0 win against Benjamin Mkapa National Stadium against Tanzania to brighten Uganda's chances of qualifying.
Obviously, we need to build on what we got in Dar es Salaam because without the Dar es Salaam victory, we couldn't have been here. We could have already given up. But we are here today because of the work we put in Dar es Salaam, the fight we put in. And as players, we know how important it is tomorrow. And of course, we don't need to spill everything that we did, the hard work that we put in Dar es Salaam in the last game against Tanzania. So we need to fight and make sure that we build onto it and win tomorrow to give us something going into the last game in the group and to make sure that we go into the Afcon in Ivory Coast.
Cranes have only managed 2 goals so far in the entire campaign.
And I believe that tomorrow we can put performance to get the result that will make us putting our dream together too.
Uganda is third in Group F with 4 points, just like second place Tanzania. Algeria tops the group with 12 points, while Niger is bottom with 2 points. Cranes will climax the group stages with a tie against Niger away from home in September.